President Trump's School Safety Commission formed in the wake of the Parkland shooting, releasing its final report today addressing school violence across America. Among the dozens of recommendations, giving states or local school districts the option to arm teachers and other school personnel. The president explaining some of the recommendations here.
These include fixing mental health laws so that families and law enforcement can get treatment immediately to those who need it, allowing highly trained school personnel to have access to firearms. According to the Department of Homeland Security, the average duration of an active shooter incident at a school is under 5 minutes. That is why it's critical to have armed personnel available at a moment's notice.
So, Jedediah, the arms, the guns thing, some people, including some students at the school, are saying, well, wait a second. We thought that the emphasis should be on keeping guns away from young people. The commission says, oh, oftentimes they get the guns from adults and the like, and they suggest giving guns to the teachers or the personnel. What do you think?
Keeping guns away from the bad guys is what we want. You know, I like the idea. Remember that these people that are going to be trained, they're going to get background checks. You're not just handing guns to any old people. Oftentimes it's military vets or people that used to work in law enforcement that are retired that I think would be a great option for people to come to the school and protect it. I think it's important because a lot of these schools that are in very rural communities, they get really nervous about if you call, you know, I'm used to living in the city. You call the police, you know, you think, okay, they're going to be here really quickly. If you're in more of a remote area, if you call for assistance, by the time those people can get to you, a lot of damage can be done. So you need to have people that are on those sites that are able to, you know, that are trained and are able to do that. And a lot of people say, oh, well, you know, the classroom is too chaotic an environment. It's not safe. I can say, as having worked in a classroom, it would make me feel really comfortable if I had people that were trained and were carrying so that I knew that if there was a bad guy with an agenda that had a plan to do damage, that they would be able to protect me and the kids.
And Jesse, another controversial element of the report was rescinding Obama-era guidelines that said, you know, we want to make sure that there isn't some kind of racial bias or bias against kids with disabilities in terms of school discipline. So instead of suspending or throwing them out, which is what I think happened with this kid, Nicholas Cruz, that instead you would do things like counseling, therapy, support of the like. What do you think?
Well, I'm sensitive to if there's, you know, racial disparity in enforcing rules, and they call it a school to prison pipeline, and I get that. But I think what happened is they took a bad situation, and the mechanism they used to correct it overcorrected. So now you have, you're selling drugs, you're punching people in the face, you're hurting girls, you're disruptive and disrespectful to the teacher, and they don't do anything to you. What we have, one teacher in South Carolina said, you have a kid who finds out that you can say F you to the teacher, flip over the table, run out of the classroom, can't suspend them. So once the kid knows you can do that, they'll do anything. So all they're saying is, instead of just putting them into these diversion programs like they did with this guy in Broward County, maybe if he does something terribly wrong, you have to hit him with a criminal charge. And I think that's a good idea.
Okay. And Dana, what do you make of the idea that you would have such a recommendation about guns and discipline coming out of the Parkland shooting? It wasn't as if the shooter was some hard minority kid, thuggish kid or something. That's not what happened here, but it seems like the president Betsy DeVos have used this as the grounds now to institute these policies.
I don't think they used it. I think that it happens that they needed to do this report anyway. There was pressure on the administration to look at some of the things that Obama had done, and they decided to do something different. And what I like about all of the report is that it's saying, let local school districts decide. Mm-hmm. And I think that is where we need to be, what we need to be doing, that those decisions are best made by the communities. And they know, as Jedediah was saying, some are rural communities, some are urban communities. Let them decide, including on discipline. I picked this up, I printed it, and I will share it with you, Juan, if you want. But USA Today had 15 teams and reporters, and they went out and they followed teachers for an entire day, one day in September, all across the country. It is shocking what these teachers have to go through. They deserve a lot more of our support, financial support, some of that's the case, but also safety from outside the classroom and also from inside the classroom. There's problems, too. So I'm all for this report. I think it's good that they put it out.
But the teachers and the parents, Greg, according to the polls, don't support arming people.
I've seen different statistics, including in Parkland, that are welcoming a lot of these changes. What I find interesting is that if you look on social media, or if you just look at the media in general, how sanctimonious they were after when saying, like, no more thoughts and prayers, when people would say, no, it's time for action. This is action.
Yep.
I mean, look, it's multifaceted. Banning of bump stocks. We don't know if that's going to change anything. It wasn't in Parkland, but it was used in other crimes. Then you've got psychiatric changes in psychiatric and counseling, things like that. You have the armed protection piece. And you're allowing the administration to act. See, the whole point of this other stuff, they're fearful of enforcing any laws because they're afraid of being punished themselves for being racist or whatever. That doesn't have anything to do with this guy, except it allowed him. The program allowed him to get away with it. So what you're doing is, a lot of this stuff is based on research and not on emotion. Number one, we know that deterrents work. Killers will choose a gun-free zone over the opposite. Any deviation from that is generally an accident, but they will, if they see even an empty parked cop car, they will drive by that. That's all you have to do. And the length of a gun attack is mitigated by the appearance of a second gun. So when somebody shows up and knows how to use the gun, the incident shrinks. So those are the facts that are based on this. And I think this is well-rounded. I think everybody gets something out of it. But a lot of gun control people, they didn't like the bump stock stuff. We'll see if that helps. And if you get armed personnel that are trained, that'll help. So I think everybody gets something out of it. And people keep saying we have to act.
Yep.
We have to act. And I think what was the last thing? A judge ruled that police have no duty to shield students in the Parkland massacre. Yeah. That was ruled. Then it's incumbent for you to be individually protected if that's the case.
But by the way, there was a guy on site with a gun.
Yeah, but he didn't act.
Well, I'm just saying he was there.
Yeah. All right.
Poorly trained.
Poorly trained. All right. You heard it here.
He didn't go in.
Well, but you know what? The thing is, what you hear is that you're going to have more incidents of people using guns improperly if there are more guns in a school
where
kids act up.
There's no science behind that.
Not if they're trained.
All right.